If Ananias and Sapphira did not die, the early church would have been a different. Apostle, I mean, Peter said, look, the feet of those that carried out your husband, they're what? They're outside there. They're going to do what? They're going to carry you. Paul told Elimas the sorcerer, he said, you should be blind until you get your sense correct. Praise God. So you always, that Jesus Christ is a lion and he's a lamb. You must ask him, when should I be a lion? Holy Spirit, when should I be the lamb? That's when you can scale through in this life. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen. Okay. Hallelujah. How many of you enjoyed today's Sunday school? Should we rewind or should we go back to our different classes? Please, if you'd like to be part of the Sunday school department, because I think we have gifted teachers amongst us, please see Brother Dickie Nido. And also, if you also still have questions, that is why we have Bible study, Digging Deep on Wednesdays. Please be encouraged to join. Please join, and then you can answer your question. We can even continue this in Bible study, God willing. I pray that as we have learned today, we'll not just be the hearer of the word, but we'll be the doer. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen.
Rise on our feet as we worship the Lord, as we praise his name, as we give him all glory, all adoration. Let's thank him for his faithfulness. Let's thank him for his spirit. Let's thank him for his love and his compassion and his mercy towards us. You are faithful from ages past, Lord. We say thank you. The one who does signs and wonders, Lord, we say thank you. Lord, we give you glory. Hallelujah. If you're happy to be in God's presence, shout hallelujah. Amen. Your hands.
Oh, karelebo sheketeni ana. Say ale ale, hey, ale ale. Come on, say ale 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 ale. From my spirit, from my. Ale ale, say ale ale. Of thanksgiving this morning,
your hands to the Lord. So
we will praise him.
Your hands,
we will praise him.
Come on.
We will praise him.
Express your joy in the Holy Ghost this morning.
Say we will praise him.
Come on, we can do better.
Hey, we will worship.
One more time.
Say we will praise. We will praise him.
We're going to demonstrate something this morning. If I told you right now that $1 million landed in your account, what would be your reaction? Some people don't want $1 million. Okay, if I told you that 1 million souls have come into the kingdom right now, what would be your reaction? If I told you that the thing you've been desiring for months or years, God has answered it right now, what would be your reaction? That same joy, as we sing this song, you will literally, that's how you will sing it. So I'm going to teach you real quick. So see.
Ah, belonche onishe iyanuse.
Show me your joy.
Belonche onishe.
Come on, do it now. Hey, here we go.
So belonche onishe iyanuwe.
You're not happy enough.
Belonche onishe iyanuwe.
Here we go. So we say,
Onisha Iyanu, Onisha Iyanu, Onisha Iyanu, Onisha Iyanu.
One more time.
So we say, body on Isha Iyanu.
Hey,
on Isha Iyanu. On Isha Iyanu.
Hey,
only you can do what no man can do, Jehovah.
Aya, where is your joy?
Jehovah, only you can do what no man can do. Jehovah. the same forever. He can never fail. Aya. Somebody blasting the Holy Ghost. Rakataika palaskele le bosote. Reketelia satai kapande. Rakatanele bosete. The glory of the Lord is in this room. Rakasika tania la baseke. Reketele le bosketelia sataya. Reketelia samanandosa. We join the host of heaven to praise you. He can never ever. You got your ten, and you are so tired. See, I sing, angels are singing.
You are worthy, O Lord.
We are singing.
You are worthy,
O Lord. Your people are singing, oh.
You are worthy,
O Lord. Angels are singing.
You are worthy, O Lord.
Angels are praising. They are worshiping. They are lifting. They are bowing unto you, Jehovah.
You are worthy, O Lord.
Your children are praising.
You are worthy, O Lord.
We are praising you.
You are worthy, oh Lord.
most holy one, to the most righteous God. Gwani gwani yo, gwani gwani yo. Iba 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 iba. Iba 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 iba. Iba 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 iba. Iba oh.
Let me to thank God and say, Father, I thank you, I bless you. Father, we worship you, we glorify you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank him. Is this how you thank God? Father, I am grateful. I say thank you. Thank you, Jesus, for your grace and your mercy. Thank you for your love and compassion. You are the God of all flesh, and there is nothing too hard for you. I thank you because you are great and greatly to be praised. You are the all-sufficient God. You are the God of heaven and earth. There is none to be compared to you. Ascribe his name unto him. He is the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Turn down the echo. He is the rose of Sharon. He is the lily of the valley. He is the bright and the morning star. Father, we say thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we worship you. Father, we bless your holy name. Thank you for your grace and your mercy. Thank you for your compassion. You are not thanking me enough. Oh Lord, I am grateful. I thank you for life. I thank you for health and vitality. I thank you for sound mind. Despite the storms of life, you have kept me. People went through 1% of what you went through, and they ran crazy. But by the mercies of God, we have been kept. Father, we say thank you. We bless you, Lord. We worship you. Thank you, Jesus. We exalt you. Thank you, Master. We exalt your holy name. We magnify you. You have another 15 seconds to say thank you, Jesus. Father, I bless you. Father, I honor you. Father, I worship you. I glorify you. With the fruit of my lips, I offer praises. I offer adoration. I offer my life unto you as a living sacrifice. Oh, Lord, accept it, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Master. We bless you, Lord. We worship you. You are who you are, yesterday, today, and forever. What you say is what you do. You never fail, you never change. You're faithful to the end. Faithful God, I worship you. I worship you. Hey, you're too faithful to fail. You're too faithful to disappoint. You're too faithful to disappoint. You've proven yourself. You've proven yourself. And I've come to realize you're too faithful to fail me. Faithful to fail me. You're too faithful to disappoint. You've proven yourself, Lord. You've proven yourself. And I've come to realize you're too faithful to fail me. You're too faithful to fail me. You're too faithful to fail me. You're too faithful to disappoint. You're too faithful to disappoint. You've proven yourself. You've proven yourself in my life. And I've come to realize you're too faithful. Great are you, Lord. Greatly too. Greatly, greatly too. Hey, Father. Great are you, Lord. Greatly, greatly to be praised. is a privilege to worship. Hey, Maker. Begin to say, Father, I thank you, I bless you. It's a joy. Ashaka pana la kaya da da da. Holy, holy, holy. Ana mana koshanda na pala koshanda. Father, we say thank you. Allah kosaka mana ya da da. Hey, Maker of all universe. Hey. Father, we say thank you. With a grateful heart, I lift my hands. Proclaiming, Lord, you reign. With a grateful heart, with a grateful heart. Father, we say thank you. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you. Father, we worship you. We bless you, Lord. You reign. Singing great, great. Greatly, Father, we say thank you. Father, we bless your holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we honor you. Hey, great you. Greatly, greatly to. Greatly to be praised. Father, we say thank you. Father, we bless your holy name. Everybody say thank you, Jesus. We have many reasons to thank him. Say, Father, thank you. You don't know how much God has fought battles on your behalf. You don't know how many battles he has fought and won. Some dreams you have is just a snippet of what God is doing in your life. Father, we say thank you. Say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Father, we are grateful. We are not mindful of the fact that you are a great God. We are not mindful of the fact that you are a good God. God is a good God. God is an awesome God. God is the Ancient of Days. If you look at your past and see where you are today, it's the mercies of God. Father, we say thank you that you have not counted sin unto us, but you have counted righteousness on our behalf. We say thank you. Everybody say thank you, Jesus. Father, we are grateful. You that can lift a beggar out of the miry clay and set him on the rock. Father, we say thank you. You that can take a man out of the pit and put him in the palace, we say thank you. Father, we are grateful. Let your name be lifted up and be glorified. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Say loud amen. We pray from one verse in the book of John chapter 6 verse 63. It is the spirit that quickeneth. There's a quickening dimension, or the quickening dimension of God. It is the spirit that what? Quickeneth. And he said, but the flesh profits nothing. It is the spirit that gives life. Give me King James, please. But the flesh profits. And he said, the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. There is something about the spirit of God that quickens a mortal man. The spirit of God came on Elijah and he outran the chariots of Ahab. The spirit of God came on David and he defeated Goliath. So you need a higher dimension of the Spirit of God in your life. Nobody has attained anything until we see Jesus in glory. Say, my Father, let your Spirit quicken me. Take me to a new dimension. Change my levels. And help me to command great things. Pray. Let your Spirit quicken me. Take me to a new dimension. Change my levels in the name of Jesus. I take that quickening spirit of God that takes a man and makes him a giant. That takes a man in his lowly state and establishes him or her. I decree and declare, Lord, let your spirit quicken me. For those that are sick, pray, let your spirit quicken that my mortal body right now and remove every sickness. Pray that prayer and begin to check yourself. The pain is gone. Check. Check your stomach. Check your back. It is gone. You can't carry a body in here and carry it back home. No. Say, my Father, if you are sick, or you know someone that is sick, pray for them now. God is limitless. You can't put him in a place. He will go there and perform that healing. Pray for that person. Holy
Holy Spirit quicken my mortal body. Many of you, you are still on the same level after 4 years. No! Father, quicken my mortal body. I want a new experience with you. I want a dimension of God that I've never seen before. You guys are praying this prayer with levity. This is a serious prayer point. My Father, quicken my mortal body. You still have the same experience with God after 4 years. That is a no. My Father, quicken my mortal body. Quicken my spirit, man. Father, I thank you. I bless you. That's all. You pray 1 minute, go to church. Oh, no! Father, quicken my experience with you. Quicken my mortal body. In Jesus' name we are prayed. Say loud amen. Amen. I was praying one time in my room. I sat down and God opened my eyes and I saw my angels. I saw them. One time I slept and I saw something at my window. I thought it was a spirit. Forgive me. So I went and on the light. I didn't say anything. God said, don't worry. That's your angel. You can have a dimension of God. See, when the Holy Spirit quickens your mortal body, it changes you so that you begin to have encounters with him. Say loud amen. What we preach here is not life until you encounter it personally. You must have a burning bush experience. Many of you, you just know theory. There's no practical aspect of the Holy Spirit in your life. That's a no. Say, my Father, quicken my mortal body. Holy Spirit, come and change me. Oh, elevate my dimension in you. Let me see things. I can sit in a place and be seeing visions. That is the quickening aspect of the Holy Spirit. God can make you a superhuman. You begin to do things that you can never do in your own flesh. Pray, my Father, quicken my mortal body. Let my experience with you be very deep. Let me begin to see the supernatural. Let me begin to know you. I take a deeper dimension of you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Master. We bless you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we are prayed. I decree and declare that the Holy Spirit will fall on us. A fresh dimension of God. Let me tell you, what you are doing before, you can do it times 100. How many know what I'm talking about? What you are doing now is very infinitesimal to what God has for you. So I decree and declare, from now on, you go in a higher dimension of God. From now on, you move in the Spirit. From now on, you understand in the Spirit. From now on, God give you the spirit of discernment. From now on, you know God for who he is. From now on, God becomes real to you. The Spirit of God guides you and guards you. May that be your portion. In Jesus' name we have prayed.
I have a Father, Almighty Father. He is King of Kings, Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. I have a Father, Almighty Father. He is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Raise up your two hands to him. I have a Father. Ah, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. I have a Father. Hallelujah. He is King of Kings, Lord of Lords. I have a Father. The father of the fatherless, the husband of widows, King immortal, invisible, the only wise God, the God that rules in the affairs of men, the God that says that it is in him we live, we move, and have our being. Lord God Almighty, we bow before you today. We say thank you. Thank you for your love, for your care, for all you have done for us. Indeed, you are our Father. There can never be any better Father than you are. We give you credit for our existence. Please accept our thanks in Jesus' name. Lord, today we ask that you will tabernacle with us. Holy Spirit, do for us what no man can do. Heal today. Deliver today. Save souls today. Cause our joy to be full. Thank you, precious Lord. In Jesus' name we have prayed. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Can we give the Lord a round of applause? He's our Father. Choir, thank you. God bless you. God bless you. Turn to your neighbor, say, God bless you. And let's tell our men, Happy Father's Day. Today that is Father's Day, we can't find the Father, so say Happy Father's Day. Well, we celebrate all our fathers in the house. Hallelujah. It's a good thing to be in the house of God. The joy that comes and fills my heart each time I come here is not quantifiable. Why? Because indeed it is a good thing to be in the presence of God. Today we'll be looking at the importance of a father. The importance of a father. I know we've heard so much about men to the point where some people feel, look, don't even talk about them at all. There's no doubt that we've had people who have hurt our feelings, people who have done things which we didn't expect. But that is not to say that fathers are not important. They are very important. Please turn with me, if you have your Bible, to 1 John chapter 2, verses 13 and 14. 1 John chapter 2, verses 13 and 14. And can we read it together, if you don't mind? 1 John 2, 13 and 14. And it says, can we read? Oh, we don't have our Bible. So let's read together. That's interesting. Okay, can we read it one more time, if you don't mind? I've written unto you, fathers, that is from the beginning. I've written unto you, young men, strong, and the word of God abides in you, and you have overcome. That is the plan of God for fathers and men. You see what God said there about them. They are strong. I wouldn't know if you will agree with me today that fathers are very important. Today we'll be looking at the difference it makes to be a father in the home. Yes, fathers are very, 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 very important to the home. When God created man, he decided to give authority to man. And through man, several things happened. Fathers are important not because of their male stature, but because of the order in the kingdom of God. And I want you to please listen to me very well today. I have come to realize that fathers have incredible value and power. They make countless differences, not only in the home, in the family, but in the society in which we find ourselves. I know we have different kind of fathers. We have spiritual fathers. These are people who helped you in your faith to know who God is. We have our physical father. These are our biological father, who through them were able to know what it means to be alive, because you could have been aborted. True? True? I know of somebody who is telling a pregnant woman, go and do what? Abort that child. We don't need that baby. And I know we have political fathers. Those are the ones who enthrone you. You want to be a senator, and it's everywhere. It's not just where we came from. Even here, we have people we call political what? I mean, you may not see them physically, but in the background, if they say we are tired of you, they are tired of you. If they say it's somebody else that the people want, it is who they want, but they say this is who the people want, whether you like it or not. That's the fellow the people want. That's the political father. But one thing God tells us from the scripture we read is that fathers are strong. Fathers have overcome the wicked one. Fathers have the word of God abiding in them. They have vast ability to touch life, especially that of their family and the world around them. Fathers have the power to build a fulfilling marriage. They have power to excel in whatever they lay their hands on. In fact, fathers are a role model for others to follow. They are men of substance. And I am carefully choosing my word because this is who God made fathers to be. God designed them to be a success story. God designed that to have a unique influence on their family. For example, a father's strength can be very powerful. Is that not true? That's why when you have done something wrong, the mom will say, don't worry. As for me, you say, when your dad comes, what happens? Because she knows you can easily maneuver and then run away and she can't pursue you. A dad's words can be fueling and inspirational. When a dad tells you this is what he wants to do, take it. A dad's smiles can instill joy and confidence in a child. And may I let you know, time with a dad can be fun and productive. Oh, somebody said, my own case was never like that. Once we hear the horn of the car coming, everybody to your tent, oh, I know. You all disappear to different words. Fathers create the happiest childhood possible for their children because they want their children to excel in life. A dad's guidance can be life-changing and it can be very foundational. When a father corrects you, his correction can be life-saving and life-giving. Adventure with a dad, oftentimes, when you look at it, can be exciting. It can be very memorable. The authoritative parenting style of the father can make children less likely to have emotional or behavioral problem. If you don't believe me, ask people who said spare the rod, and the same system in which we find ourselves, we say only talk to them because they have what? Ears. They can hear you loud and clear. You don't need to apply what? The rod. Because when you do so, you are being mean, wicked, and on what? Abuse, thank you. We have all manner of words we use. But they forgot that the same Bible says foolishness is in whose heart? The father? On the child. That the only thing that the child will respond to us at that time is what? I read it in the scripture. So, his children are more likely to do well socially, academically, relationally, and developmentally. The same system that said don't cane them, when they become a nuisance, they will say, no, this one cannot stay in the society. So they incarcerate them. If you look at the number of people who are not beaten, but we are spoken to behind bars, you will know what we are talking about. Don't touch them. But when they become a nuisance, we can't afford to have them. Where? In the society. So we need to do what? Keep them where they belong. So which one is better? To have corrected that child or to allow the system to do what? Brethren, today we are here to honor all fathers. And to honor means to publicly what? Celebrate. You may not understand what I'm saying, but I know what I'm talking about. It's not all fathers that are still in the home today. Some did what? They abandoned the home and did what? They left. Leaving who? And to do what? So that's why those who are still there, what should we do? You are not talking to me. We should celebrate them. Is that not true? We should celebrate them. Fathers are a rare gift. You see, we've had several sermons about fathers, how they are not this. No, today I came fully loaded to tell you that fathers are very important. Many of the things they do, not too many people can do it. And I'm telling you the truth. Except you are in our shoes, you will know what it means to be a father. The other day I was talking to my son. I had the son, his own son, crying. I said, what did you do? He said, look, the boy just do. I said, you have just started. The boy just do what? You can come and ask me what you did. So what it means to be what? A father. Being a father is a privilege to experiencing the magnification of God's love. That is one thing I noticed. God wants children to honor their father. Not because of what and who they are now, but because what God meant them to be. I can tell you that people who do not have a father figure in their life, I'm telling you, it's very visible in life. Very visible. To be a father is not a joke. Zechariah chapter 4 verse 6 tells us it is not by might. That what it says? He said, not by might, not by power, but by my word. And that's why we're looking at the Holy Spirit. If you're a father, there is nothing you can do except the Holy Spirit helps you. You can't give what you don't have. Except the Holy Spirit helps you. So if you have found one father who is caring, who is loyal, who does not mess up, who is available, because we have fathers that are not available, you better fight to keep them. Because Proverbs 20 verse 6, I'm not the one saying now, and I would want us to read it. Proverbs 20. He said, fathers are an endangered species. Oh, somebody is laughing. They are endangered what? Hey, let's read it together now. Proverbs 20, verse 6. He said, he that found what? He said, a faithful man who can do what? He said, most men will proclaim everyone his own goodness. But a faithful man who can what? If you have found one who is caring, please do what? you better fight to keep them. We should be full of thanks to God for our fathers. You never know the worth of water until the well dries up, and then you become thirsty. Ask families who do not have the privilege and pleasure of having them around. Mike Murdoch was giving an example of her own sister. She has now married four times. The fourth marriage still failed. Somebody was asking her, what happened? She said if she had fought very hard to keep the first one, the way she's fighting to keep the fourth one, he said things would have been better. I have come to realize that marriage is a ministry to one person. And I'm trying to explain to you the work fathers do. Marriage is what? It's a ministry. And I want you to realize that. Not to two persons, but to one person that you have dedicated your life to. It is sowing and dedicating your entire life for the success of another person. So when we're talking about prayer, it is because you don't have enough on your plate that you say you won't pray. If you have enough, you know that there are so many things you need to do what? To pray for. Trust me, fathers know that they are responsible for the submission of their wives. But they are investing. They are in doing what? Marriage is a great investment. And it's not just small. Everything to ensure that the marriage works. Trust me, it is a lot of investment. And I want to pray for all fathers that God will continue to strengthen you. Thank you for not giving up. Thank you for not throwing in the towel like some other people say, I quit. And once they quit, they quit. Somebody was speaking the other day how it would be difficult for him to live without the husband. But before we knew it, she ran away with a 17-year-old boy. Now, some of these things, they don't look real, but in the world in which we find ourselves today, as those of you who are in social media, you see what happens now. You see a 70-year-old woman from the U.S. Having an affair with a 16-year-old Nigerian and promising them to do what? That they will bring them to where? So she can't find anybody from the U.S. She's 50, she's 55, she's 60. Doing what? That's to tell you. You should have asked her, what happened to the one that she had before? Research has provided an insight into the fact that sons who have a good dad and relationship with their dad tend to handle stress more effectively and develop self-control. I was asking a child some of these questions because we'll look at who exactly is a father. Maybe we should look at who is a father. A father is not a woman like some of us will be made to believe in the system we find ourselves. Because in the lesbian world, we have fathers and what? And mother. Even the gay people, they have what? They have father and mother. Oh, yes. But when we talk about father here, we are talking about a male and a head coach of his family. He's the nourisher, he's the provider, he's the protector. The sole authority recognized by God to bring divine covenant to bear upon not only the children, but the entire family. I began to wonder, if God does not see the need for a man, when he created Adam, he gave him what? Job to name, give names to animals. The Father is the connecting rod by which all the plans of God are transmitted to the next generation. That's why when you look at the Bible very well, you find that when God wants to bless, he blesses through who? The man. Is that not true? That's exactly what happened. That's why in some homes, they will fight tooth and nail. I know people who did everything possible. Oh, they have a child, but it's not a male. They said, ah, who will continue the... I said, no, a child is a child. For me, because whether you like it or not, that child will still... We have different examples in the Bible of somebody who did not even have what? A male child. And the children were still able to stand, even in the midst of the societies of elders, to proclaim that, look, yes, our father may not have what, but we are here. And they gave them all that belongs to them. What are we saying, brethren, is that the Father is the image and the glory of God created to bear authority. He gives identity to the family. That's why you call yourself Mrs. Adams. Is that not true? Even people who are divorced, they are still bearing what? Bill Gates' wife did not change her name. She's still bearing what? Melinda Gates. Identity. Identity. Genesis 3:16 tells us that the identity of a wife is only found in her husband. And a father is an example of righteousness. A man who has chosen to live like Jesus Christ, commune with him in prayer. Deuteronomy 6:6 tells us that when you look at a man, you find that he demonstrates love, faithfulness, not only to his wife, but to his children. And the best gift you can ever give your children is to unconditionally love their mother. If you love their mother, find that things will work out. A father teaches, instructs, and disciplines his children. These are the roles of a father. But what exactly did we see in men that we chose to honor them today? I asked a child in this church some time ago. He said, how did you know how to drive a car? You know what he said? He didn't say, my mother taught me. Who? He said, my father. I watched my father and just did what I saw. I asked another question. Why did you refuse to argue with that neighbor when he said some unknown, unkind words to you? You know what he said? He said, I just did what I saw my father do. Why did you stick out in that difficult job when most people will say, I quit? You know what he said? I just did what I saw my father. He doesn't quit at the least provocation. He looks and see, is there anything that can be done? I asked another question. Why did you give the clerk, because we were talking about integrity the other time, the clerk back the money when he gave you too much change? You know what she said? Oh, I only did what I saw my dad did, that he wouldn't take something that does not belong to him. That when we come back home, we brought a pencil or a pen or something that is not supposed to be in our bag. The question he asked is that, where did you get this from? I asked another question. Why did you pray and thank God for good times and sometimes things that are not so good? What the child told me was this. I just did what I saw my father do. then why do you pay tithe? Why do you give? Why do you praise God? I only did what I saw. So that's to tell you that what you do have what? A lot of what? Impact. What you are doing, you are telling that child that this is what matters to me. If you sit at home reading the newspaper, not bothering to take, that child, they know what is important. So when you get old, you know what they do? They have studied you all throughout the years. So they give to you what you need. I have realized that people who actually have lived with their father will not take them to that home. What do you call them? Mm-mm. They won't. They'll say, it's my dad. I have visited because I had been privileged to assist my wife. I will go to some places and I will see how old these people are, and I will thank them. Say, why are you thanking me? It's just, I knew who this man used to be. This is the last time he has to live. He must do what? Enjoy it. I'm not going to dump him in one nursing home. Why? Because of who they saw the dad. I once heard a story about a girl who hated her father so much. For ages, she never spoke to her dad. Never set her eyes on him. But as the year rolls by, the girl now, of course she's a woman now, began to regret her action and wanted to reach out to the dad. Shortly before Father's Day, she realized that her dad would be 80 years old. So she went to the store, bought some items, heartfelt gifts, and said she was going to send it to the dad. She expressed her regret and everything she has done in the past that she knew she shouldn't have done, trying to make it over with the dad. She sent the card, she sent all the gifts, waited for a response, but a couple of days she was told that everything she sent is still where? In the mailbox, because the man was already expired. Man and fathers are very, very important. This is not to say that men don't have challenges. Oh, there are quite a number of challenges. But still, we want you to know that we appreciate fathers. Every man that you see walk through that door, not only this door, but any other church, are bleeding from deep wounds inflicted on them, which they may not be able to do what? You know, women, they can, every little thing, they have a way of expressing themselves. Is that not true? Yeah. Uh-huh. But men, you must have to wind them. In that house, at times, even when I'm not doing well, I'm sick, you will never hear it from what? From my mouth. Because I just believe that, like a man, you can do what? I mean, you can weather this. But when my wife begins to say, this guy, the way is, something is wrong somewhere. But what we are saying is that by challenges, men, when I say challenges, I mean there are obstacles that overwhelms fathers. And these challenges, you know, they destroy the ability to be fathers, good fathers. Somebody once said about Trump, he said, well, he may not be a good what? Husband, but he's what? So you see the two roles now. If you're a father, you're a father to somebody, but you are a husband to somebody. Romans chapter 8, 18 to 23. God meant men to be men that God will have pleasure in. Moses, the man of God, once complained about burden of leading the people. He declared, I can't take it what? Anymore. And God told him, don't worry. The spirit that is on you will do what? Will give it to some elders. There was a time Elijah too came and said the burden was what? Said he was not better than his forefathers. Just like Moses, leading a family in America is like leading a small patrol through the war, either in Afghanistan or where the other place now, Ukraine. If you ask those of us who have been fathers back home and here, you find that there is a lot of what? Do I have witness in the house? There is a lot of difference. Back home, you have the driver, you have, what do you call it? Even me, I have secretary. When our last baby was, I take him into my with my car, take it to the, I tell the secretary, today, this is the job you are doing. Don't worry, don't type for me. But here, it is per hour. Is that not true? When I first came, when you don't go to pick the child, they will say, well, we give you 5 minutes or 10 minutes. After that, every minute, how much? $10. So you know what we are talking about. So there is a lot of war going on just to, you know, make men handicapped. Some have been breadwinners back home. They got here only for them to begin to learn what? Some other kind of what? Trade. For some of them, it has not been very easy. They've not been able to acclimatize. Let me tell you something. There is a lot of casualty list that is out there, and I want you to just know a few of them. Out of 2 marriages in America, they end in divorce. 1 out of 2 marriages. And the median age for men in that category are 34. Women are 30. Today, 2 out of every 5 households is maintained by a woman with no husband present. Today, we have enough teenagers to fill a stadium who will practice prostitution just to support themselves. Some even go into drug addiction. The reason is because there is no what? 1 million teenage girls who are told will get pregnant out of wedlock this year. Why? No father figure. 500,000 of these girls will abort their babies because they won't be able to take care of those child. Of all the 14-year-old girls alive today, 40% will be pregnant by their 19th birthday. You may say, is this possible? It is. I have a story, and I won't be too specific so that you don't know. I was a particular family. No father, no husband in the house. They have these small children that are teenage. She is only focused on, you know, computer, the work, and things like that. These children will go, they will come back from school. And they will bring school friends. Is that not true? They will be in the sitting room laughing and dancing and shouting. She said, is what? They are doing school. Only for the girl to now come and confess to a distant relative who is several miles away that this boy he brings home every time they come from school was assaulting her right inside their own house in the sitting room. This woman never knew anything. Why? No father figure. By the time she had, her heart broke. And I'm in the room, not sleeping. How come? Father figure. Father figure. Brethren, we know what we are talking about. And that's why we said we need to celebrate our fathers. So what are the obstacles? What are the challenges that fathers have? The challenges are many, but yet they are real. Fathers are exhausted. Some are exhausted, trying to juggle the demands of job, family, and so many other things together. Many fathers are victims of shattered dreams. And I'm telling you the truth. Many felt they were fulfilled where they were coming from. But when they got here, they have to learn different kind of what? Trade to be able to adjust. We have fathers who feel trapped in an unhappy marriage. And simply because God says, I do what? I hate divorce. So they did what? They stuck in, even though they are not happy. I have seen fathers who the wife will tell, I brought you into this America. If you don't behave, you better straighten up. Or else by the time I finish with you, people in your village, they will look at you, they won't be able to recognize you. So how many men can come out and begin to tell you this is what they were being told? There are challenges, man. Some of them, they conform just because they want to do what? They want peace to do what? We have fathers who are struggling to find a sense of purpose in the midst of a daily routine. Some of these fathers we are talking to you about have insecurity boiling inside of them. We have fathers whose hearts ache for their children who are rebellious with special needs. We have fathers who are being intimidated by the devil. Satanic intimidation. We have some fathers who have contention with unsubmissive wives. Some fathers gravitate toward sex and use of substance. Some will rather play video games and drink beer with friends because real husband and dad are having issues. We have volatile dads because once you step on their toes, what happens? They flare up. 1 minute, they are fun. The other time, they are what? They are red in their face and furious. How about marital ineffectiveness, financial ineffectiveness? Some are even sick. But who did they talk to? We have fathers who have issues with drinking. We have fathers who have issues with pornography. Why? I have another example. There was a time my wife was aware. 2 a.m., a couple called me. What is going on? Pastor, this, you know, I have to drive all the way from Snellville to Riverdale. Only for me to get there to go and settle what? What? Quarrel. Hey, Pastor, this is my job laptop. And this man has, I don't know what name do you people call, put virus into it. Why? Because he was using it to go to the big boobs and the small boobs. And I mean, we hear all manner of things. I said big boobs and small boobs. So he said it's a .com. I said, I didn't know there is a .com like that. He said, what am I going to tell them at my place of work? When they look at the laptop and see that he... Because when you go to those sites, definitely it comes with what? A lot of virus. So that was why they were fighting. When? 2 a.m. So we have fathers who hurt. And in spite of all the above, I want you to know that fathers are still what God has made them to be. What did we see in fathers? Because I'm going to round up now. That we want to celebrate them today. 9 things we appreciate in you and we admire in you, fathers, for sticking it out. 1 is because you are diligent. The Bible says, see thou a man diligent in his what? He will do what? And not mean men. Proverbs 17:17 says, fathers are friendly because that is who they are supposed to be. Why do we celebrate them today? Fathers are merciful. Matthew 5:7 says, Matthew chapter 5 verse 7 says that if you are merciful, God too will be what? You will obtain mercy. We notice that fathers are godly because they want to come to church. They want to desire God in their life. Fathers can be encouraging. Acts chapter 4, 36 to 37. Fathers are generous, and that is why we celebrate them today. Some of them will give everything they have just to make sure that other people are comfortable. Some don't even mind if they don't have a car, as long as members of the family are well taken care of. Fathers are kind. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 32 tells us about them, that they are what? Very kind, generous. They are discreet. And the Bible says, when we say discreet, it means they are wise. Proverbs 15, verse 2 tells us that. And we celebrate fathers today because they are faithful. Faithful not only to their children, faithful to the wife, faithful to God. Thank you. So what are the things we can do to continue to encourage and to honor fathers in our midst? Number one is this. Inspire them. What did I say? Remind them that God is the one that has chosen them to be a father, and he will continue to equip and support them. Number two, and continue to encourage them. Give them the gift of a daily reminder that, look, you can do it. I've asked one or two men, why did they abandon their... You'll be surprised some of the reasons they gave. Abandoned a wife and children and ran away. What is that thing that is pursuing you? By the time they told me, I knew all they needed was just a little pat on what? The back. Affirm them. Let them know what they are doing is good, that they're doing a good job. And appreciate them for the little they are able to provide. And stop comparing them. Is it not your mate you finished at UIC the same year? There is a man, I won't be too specific. The wife drove him crazy. I think they went and had a men's fellowship in somebody's house. When they got there, they saw swimming pool. They saw everything. Say, hey, see now. This is what we tell you. This is your meat. See, the house, swimming pool, everything is there. And the man felt bad. Say, hey, so if I can't provide swimming pool, but at least I'm able to provide what? A roof. Is that not enough? Nurture them. Compliment them. Compliment them. And please, for the women, let's respect them. Respect their judgment, opinion, and decision. Even if they prove to be wrong, don't say, I keep telling you that thing you are always saying. You see where you have put us now. If you have listened to me, don't let us do it that way. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Because of time, I'm going to stop here. There is so much to say. But you are here, you have not given your life to Christ. You may be a man. I have painted a kind of what God is expecting you and I to be as what? As a man. But you can't give what you don't have. If you are here, you have not given your life to Christ. The Bible says in John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. I've always told people that when God is looking in the direction of a man, he's not looking at your face. He's looking at what? Your heart. The mark of a man after God's heart is that God looks at what? Your heart. Is the heart saved? Does the heart embrace the word of God? Does the heart of this man obey God? Does this heart praise? Does it worship? That is what God is looking for. And this is can only be possible if you do what? You embrace Jesus, because he's the Father of all fathers. I'd like us to bow down heads even as we pray. Father, today we want to thank you. We bless your name. Our heart cry is that as other people look at us as men, as fathers, they will see the life of Jesus shining forth in our lives. Lord, walk in our lives and make us to be that man that will live and be a role model for you in Jesus' name. I want us to please, if you know you have not given your life to Christ, I want to plead with you. You may be a man, you may not be, you may be a woman. This is very important. You need to give your life to Christ because he's the only one who can rescue, heal every hurt. He's the only one who can help you to forgive and forget. He's the only one who can help you to be the person he ordains you to be. Ah, Father, is there anybody here? I'd like to pray with you. It's a moment of decision. Bible says the only thing that comes after death is judgment. God wants you to be the kind of person that he can relate with. He wants you to be that man, woman, who will bring pleasure to him. So whether you're a man or a woman, this is a call for salvation. Will you embrace Jesus? Will you embrace what he did on the cross of Calvary? Will you engage the Holy Spirit? Father, we thank you. We bless your holy name. We give you all the glory. I want us to please stand up as we pray. I want us to pray for the men, because the greatest thing you can give to them is equally to do what? To pray for us. To do what? To pray. Many are in obscurity. God took Anna from obscurity. He took David out of the cave of Adullam. I want us to pray for the men. Isaiah 60, 1 to 3. We are going to take our prayer from there. Isaiah 60, 1 to 3. It says, Isaiah 60 said, arise, shine. Men, your light has come. You are coming out of obscurity. And the glory of the Lord is what? The glory of the Lord has risen upon you. Everything that is causing your head to be bowed, God will lift up today in Jesus' name. Verse 2 says, for behold, the darkness shall cover the earth. Gross darkness, the people. But the Lord shall do what? God is going to arise on your behalf. His glory shall be seen upon your life. Verse 3 says, and the Gentiles shall come to thy light, and kings to the brightness of thy rising. In other words, you are coming out of obscurity. When we talk about obscurity, what we are saying is you are unknown, you are unnoticed, you are uncelebrated, you are unappreciated, you are unwelcome, unremembered, unassisted, undecorated. But today, God will come through for you. Amen. I say God will come through for you. Amen. from today you'll be singing a new song. Your shame will be displaced by God's fame. Your disgrace will be eliminated by God's grace. Every sickness in your body, receive healing in the name of Jesus. Spiritually, you are coming out of obscurity. Professionally and career-wise, you are coming out of obscurity. Maritally, you are coming out of obscurity. Financially, God is bringing you out of obscurity. For those of us who go to school academically and socially, you are coming out of obscurity. I come against the spirit of rejection in your life. For those who are feeling bad, God come through for you in Jesus' name. Father, please take over the life of fathers in this church in Jesus' name. Some of them are on a long queue of life. Lord, put them on the fast lane of glory. What you did in John chapter 5 to the man at the pool of Bethsaida, do for them in Jesus' name. If you're a man, place your hand on your head, if you don't mind. And for everybody, if you desire. And declare, say, by the power of the Holy Spirit, I will no longer be hidden. I will no longer be in obscurity. The lifter of heads will lift up my head. I will no longer be depressed. Oh, I decree that the Lord will lead me out of every fiery furnace. Some are owing. God, lead me out of failure. Lead me out of defeat and fruitless effort in the name of Jesus. Where others have failed, I will excel. Where others are rejected, I will be accepted. Where others are struggling, I will survive. I will survive financially. Where others are denied, I will receive mercy. I speak testimony into my life. I speak prosperity into my life. I speak blessing into my life. In the name of Jesus, every dust covering my glory shall be unveiled. Everything that has held me on one spot today, give way in the name of Jesus. Thank you, precious Father. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Our Father in heaven, we want to thank you. In accordance to Isaiah 8:18, Lord, I'm praying that these men will carry the spirit of the living God. If we'll be full of testimonies. You're a partaker of the prophecy in Isaiah 8:18 in Jesus' name. Because by miracles, signs, and wonders, God will cause your life to be on the upward move in the name of Jesus. May signs and wonders not only follow you, may you be a sign, a wonder to your generation in Jesus' name. May the wonders of God be constantly displayed in your life. May your life be a marvel to those who know you before. And I'm praying that the Lord will continue to magnify himself in your life. May the Lord increase you exceedingly. May the Lord enlarge your scope and your coast in Jesus' name. May you excel in edifying and in adding value to the life of your family in the name of Jesus. Every form of depression and sickness, give way in Jesus' name. In this season, may you operate under the open heavens of heaven. In the name of Jesus, your life shall not know drought. May the Lord send you rain, abundant rain. May the rain of his spirit come upon your life. In the name of Jesus, so shall it be. You will never labor in vain. you will not be barren. You are bringing up much fruit in Jesus' name. Bountiful fruit in Jesus' name. Yes, you shall not be disappointed. God will exceed all your expectations in Jesus' name. It will be well with you. You will testify of the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. So shall it be. Jesus' name we have prayed. In Jesus' name we have prayed. So shall we say Happy Father's Day to our fathers? Thank you. God bless you.
Let's stretch forth our hands and pray that the Lord will bless him in return. He has released blessings upon us this morning, fathers and every one of us. Let's pray that the Lord himself will bless him from heaven. The Bible says that he that waters shall be watered, that the Lord himself will be the glory and the lifter up of his head, that the Lord will increase him on all sides. The Lord will enlarge his territory. It will increase his scope of influence in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for our father in the house that you have used this morning to bless us. We pray the Lord will bless him from above in the mighty name of Jesus. You continue to use him to make impacts even in this generation and generations to come. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Praise the Lord. Have we been blessed this morning? Today is Father's Day, and we are celebrating all the fathers in the house. But we all know that we also have a Father in heaven. Our God is the ultimate Father. Some of us don't have physical, earthly fathers again, but we know we have a Father that is the Father of the fatherless, and He's there for us. He's the Father of those that still have fathers, and He's the Father of the fatherless. Let's celebrate God this morning. He's the ultimate Father. And one of the ways God, we can please, just as when we obey our earthly fathers, they are happy. We also do things that will provoke the blessings of our heavenly Father. And that is when we obey him. When he gives us commandments and instruction and we obey him, we provoke blessings. We know the story of Jacob in the story of Isaac in the book of Genesis chapter 27. He desired something and he called his son that give me something so that I will bless you. And of course, even though Jacob went to supplant his brother and he brought, and the father blessed him because he was able to fulfill the desire of the heart of the father. He provoked that blessing. And this morning we want to provoke the blessings of our father by obeying his commandments, and we give our tithes. So if you're in the house this morning, you have your tithes, can you please come forward? That's the way we can provoke the blessing of our Father, by obeying him. So if you're in the house, you have it physically here, or you've transferred it in the course of the week, or you have it electronically sent, can we please come forward as we pray? And I'm going to be reading from that blessing that Abraham, that Jacob gave, Isaac blessed Jacob. And it's in the book of Genesis chapter 27. And I'll read from verse 27. Genesis 27, verse 27. And he came near and kissed him. And he smelled the smell of his raiment and blessed him and said, see, the smell of my son is as the smell of a field which the Lord has blessed. Therefore, God give thee of the dew of heaven. I believe we say amen. And the fatness of the earth and plenty of corn and wine. Let people serve thee, and let nations bow down to thee. Be Lord over thy brethren, and let thy mother's sons bow down to thee. Cursed be the one, be everyone that curseth thee, and blessed be the one that blesseth thee. Our Father and our God, we want to thank you for this blessing of a father over the children. Because your children have obeyed your commandments and they've brought their tithes into your house, we pray that, Lord God, you will multiply your blessing upon them in the name of Jesus. You will bless every of their income in the name of Jesus. We decree promotions, open doors for them in the name of Jesus. When men say there is a casting down, let them say there is a lifting up in the name of Jesus. We pray that, Lord God, you cause them to be lenders unto nations in the name of Jesus. And you rebuke the devourer for their sake. Nothing will devour their health. Nothing would divorce their marriages. Nothing would divorce their careers. Nothing would divorce their walk with you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, because you have answered us. We pray for the remaining that is in their hands, in their bank accounts. We ask that, Lord, you breathe your breath of life upon it and you will multiply it in a thousandfold. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Praise the Lord. We can please drop our tithes. It's time for us also to give our offering. Whether we have it physically, we can cash app it or Zelle it or pay by any form of electronic transfer that is displayed on the screen for us. So the choir will lead us as we sing and we give unto God cheerfully.
Hallelujah. You are the mighty God, the great I am. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The great I am, hallelujah, hallelujah. Mighty God, you are the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Given our offering to you. We pray the Lord you will bless us and you will bless our offerings in the name of Jesus. We pray that because we've given to you this morning, you cause men to give back to us good measures, pressed down, shaking together, and running over in the mighty name of Jesus. Because you are the God that gives seed to the sower and bread to the eater, we pray the Lord God will not lack what to give to you always in the name of Jesus. And this is the least we would ever give to you because you will promote us and enlarge our territory. In Jesus' mighty name we have given. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Come on, we can do better than that. It's a beautiful morning in God's presence. Praise the Lord! Come on. I mean, it's a special Sunday. How many of us agree it's a special Sunday? Praise the Lord. It's Father's Day. It's Father's Day. So I want everyone in the house, a woman, every woman, there's every child in the house. I want us all to shout, Happy Father's Day. Can we all do that? Happy Father's Day! We love you all. We love you all, men. Praise the Lord. I'm here to invite some special group of people to come out here to present for our fathers. The Children's Church, we've prepared something special for all the men here today. So I want to invite the Children's Church, the toddlers, and come on. Come on, guys. Let's give them a hand, round of applause.
Church and Happy Father's Day.
We the Children Church have a small presentation to appreciate our fathers.
As you listen, God bless you.
Amen.
Of
You can do better than that. You can do better than that. Come on, let's give him a round of applause. You can do better than that. Okay, we're going to invite the preteens to come out next.
Good afternoon, church. Good afternoon, church. How are we doing today on this blessed Father's Day? Today, we will be presenting a drama. It's called Father's Love, and I hope you guys enjoy. Testing.
Hey, Dad. Yes? I need my share of the money right now.
Right now. Do we need more rights? We need more rights.
Thanks.
The father divided his property between them. Not long after that, the son got all he had.
Hey, what is that?
Thank you.
I would like to buy it. How much is it?
How much you got?
I got 5 coins.
I can give you 1 for 5 coins.
After he had spent everything, there was a severe famine. So the beggar went to the first citizen. He begged for the food, but she denied. The young son went to the second citizen, but she denied also. But then when he went to the third citizen, she hired him as a job, and he told him to go and wipe the floor.
I'm going to go back to my father and ask for forgiveness. Father, please forgive me for all I have done. Please.
Yes, I shall forgive you. I missed you. And now I shall give you, come here. I will give, can you prepare my finest fattened cow for my son, please?
My dad, the best friend I have ever had, he carried me with his arms of joy.
always smiling from above. Your hand is my comfort, lifting me up when I fall short. Your voice makes me strong, teaching me what's right and what and wrong. Your smile says it all, and I promise to make you proud and good.
A father's love, so pure and true, reflects our God in all we do. In every hug, in every care, we see God's love, he's always there. Just like our dads who guide our way, God's light our path each night and day. With wisdom, strength, and gentle hands, he leads us to his promised land. In times, joys, and times of fear, our fathers and gods are always near. With love so strong and arms so wide, they lift us up there by our sides. Matthew 7:11 says, "You see how much more will your father be if dads on earth show love us so grand. God's love us for we understand. So here's to dads, both near and far, who show God's love just so who they are. With grateful hearts, and we say today, Happy Father's Day.
Happy Father's Day.
Come on, give them a round of applause. A round of applause. They deserve more than that. Okay, and next we're going to invite the Teens Church to come out and do their presentation. Come on now, guys.
Thank you. apostle of the gospel, his love we trace, a shepherd, a guardian, our saving grace. The Lord is our shepherd, I shall not want. In Psalm 23, his care does not charm. He leads us to gentle pastures, his love is pastures green, a father's love, pure and serene. In Luke 15, the prodigal son returns. A father's heart, his children yearns. He runs, he embraces with joy, he greets. No judgment, no anger, just love complete. In Matthew 10, his care is so clear, providing, sustaining, he draws us near. He knows our needs, each size, each plea, a father who listens endlessly. A shepherd seeks his one last sheep, in Luke 15, he promises he keeps. He pursues with love, not willing to lose, a father whose presence we never refuse. If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father who is in heaven give good things to those who ask of him? Matthew 7:11, his heart laid bare, a love undeniable, a father in heaven beyond compare. From ancient scrolls, his goodness shines, a father eternal in every line. Good, good father, forever adored, in the Bible embrace our spirits are restored. There is something special about fathers, and that's why the Bible mentioned it 265 times. On this Father's Day, we're here to say, we love you, dear Father, in every way. For all you do, both big and small, even if it looks like you don't show it, we sincerely love and cherish you. Your love, our strength, we cherish it all. Your guide and wisdom with gentle care, in every step you're always there. Your sacrifices, your unspoken deeds are always to fill our deepest needs. Thank you, dear fathers, for all you do, for the laughter, the lessons, and seeing us through. Today we honor and celebrate you with hearts full of love, and we say,
Happy Father's Day!
I want to ask a question. I have a pop quiz right now to ask. How many times does the Bible mention Father? He just said it. 265 times. That's how special fathers are. Praise the Lord. Okay, next I'm going to call on a very special person. The women, it's the women's time now. So I'm going to call on Sister Lara.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So we are taking it to a different dimension. We realize that our fathers, they are very skillful. God has really blessed them with great skills that you'll be surprised. But before we can see that skill actualized within the church, right, we want to do a test. We're going to get some tools, and then we have it. We have our father. We have our fathers show their skills, and we pray. And we pray that as you listen and see them in action, may the Lord bless you in Jesus' name. So the way we're going to do it, I'm going to need five families. I'm going to need the wife and the husband. So I'm going to need a representative from here, from here, from here, from here, from here. So please, I need a representative from each row, please. Or else I'll call names. Let's make it easy. Okay. I will start from Deacon Adams and Mommy Adams. Mommy Adams, please encourage them with clapping. Mommy Adams, it's a great honor to have you here. So Daddy, you're going to stand behind Mommy, right? And Mommy's going to say, okay, please just talk to each other because this role is all set. Where is Sister Clara? Sister Clara and Brother Oguji, come on. Please encourage them. You people don't understand. Okay. Have you decided on this role? I'm coming back. Okay. You know there's a strategy to this thing, eh? Okay, our daddy and our mommy, please graciously clap for them, please. Have you people decided on this role? Okay, as the Spirit leads, our couple here, please. Encourage them now. Okay. have your seat. We have one final. Okay. I will make it easy for you, Mom and Daddy. Mommy and Daddy, please.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sister Mercy. Mommy, it's such a great honor to have. Can't you see? Please encourage them now. Okay, as women, you know the way we wake up Sunday morning and we are trying to get all these facials together, right? And then we thought about that. God has given us great men that can, as we are doing the eyebrows, they can be doing the eshe. Please bring the tools. So what we are going to do is, just stand here. We are going to have our men tie this thing called gele. And you people will be the judge. Mommy, you're already teaching that. This is for you, Daddy. This is for you. This is for you. We have it as you want it. So this is for you. So you people will be the judge. These men are skillful. So let's just sit back, relax, and watch them in action. So when I say, please, I need a timekeeper. It's just going to take about 1 minute. Is 1 minute okay? Wait. You can't do auto gele, yeah. You can't do auto gele. Okay, they say we should give them two minutes or three. 2 minutes is okay. 2 minutes is okay. So when I say, wait, oh, daddy, wait. So when I say action, you start. 1, 2, action. Please encourage them. Let's start encouraging them by clapping. Please encourage them by clapping. It's not easy, oh. Hold on. I don't understand. What happened in this place? What happened here? Daddy, while some amiable men are still trying to figure it out, what's your secret?
Somehow I've been seeing her doing it. So just anyhow.
Please jam your hands together for that. Okay. Oh, wow. You look so pretty. Deacon Adams, what is your secret to tying gele in less than 2 minutes? You are breaking Guinness Book of Records. What is the secret?
Just as she had do it every time. Although she normally have people to help her do, but I just...
Okay. Mr. Oguji, what's your... Sister Clara, you look like today's bride, though. What's your secret? What's the time? Do we still have time? All our men tie this gele with less than 2 minutes. What's your secret, sir?
I just tied it like a scarf, but I know that gele, they usually use a pin and so many stuff, so I can say that our materials are not complete.
I think that's justifiable, thank you. Okay, Daddy, Mommy looks very nice. Yeah, Mommy, it's like the gele rhyme, your skin color. Daddy, please tell us the secret. We did less than 2 minutes.
Actually, I don't have a secret. I use my instinct. Then I've seen people done this before, so it clicked in my head, then I just did it the way I did it, so I don't know.
Spiritest of all. Praise God. What is... I think you took it to another generation. Because you know the way we are tying gele now. The next generation, this is Gen Z. But this one, I don't have a name for it right now. Daddy, you are thinking ahead, right? You are moving forward. What is this? Because before you know it now, people start tying gele and covering their faces. What is the secret?
I'll watch YouTube next time.
He said he will watch YouTube next time. Please, let's give a round of applause for all of them. They did so well. They did so well. Thank you so much. You can please have your seat. Praise God.
Praise the Lord. Come on, let's give the men a round of applause. They did awesome. They did awesome. Praise the Lord. Lastly, I'm going to invite Mommy Nido to come do a short presentation.
Praise the Lord. Happy Father's Day. Amen. Please, I want all our women to be on their feet, please. This light. If you are not a man, you are a woman. So please, I want every ladies in the house to be on their feet, please. As we appreciate our daddy. Daddy, we really want to thank you. We want to appreciate you as Women of Peace Assembly. We appreciate you for your show of love. We want to thank you for all you do for us, for your teachings, for your text messages, for your show of love, for all you've been doing for us, encouragement and all. We want to really appreciate you from the depths of our hearts. As women of this house, we say thank you, Daddy, that the Lord will continue to strengthen you, the Lord will continue to bless you, the Lord will do for you and your family what you cannot do for yourself, in the mighty name of Jesus. I want to appreciate you on behalf of all our women with this.
Thank you.
Accept it for us in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, and to all the men in the house, we say thank you for your show of love. We say thank you, thank you, thank you. Please don't mind us as women, as mothers. At times we do shakara, you know, but from the depths of our hearts, we really love you. So let the women, let us go around and begin to appreciate our men. Give them a hand of shake, appreciate them for all they do for us. Happy Father's Day to you all. That was more. Happy Father's Day. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I don't know if I can do this. On behalf of the men, we thank all our mothers as well. May the Lord continue to increase you. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Do we have some visitors in our midst today? If you're worshiping with us for the very first time, can you please wave your hand if today is your first time in the Redeemed Christian Church of God Peace Assembly? Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. If today is your first time in the Redeemed Christian Church of God Peace Assembly, can you please wave your hand? Okay. Well, I guess we're doing evangelism after the service today. Praise the Lord. Our announcement, our service is 9 a.m. in the morning. We have the workers' meeting every Sunday, 9:30 we have a Sunday school, and at 10 o'clock we have a Sunday service. We try to finish as much as possible before 12, but today we're honoring our fathers, praise the Lord. Wednesday we have the Digging Deep from 7 to 8 p.m. And on Fridays we have prayers. Last Fridays we always have Solution Night. This Friday I'm not sure because of the... Okay, we're going to be having the Zoom from 8 to 9 p.m. this Friday. Praise the Lord. And the church convention in Dallas, Texas is on Wednesday, June 19th, this Wednesday, to the 21st, Friday. The Holy Ghost night is on Friday. Praise the Lord. There is the evangelism after the service. Praise the Lord. If there's any more announcement, it shall be brought to us. And I still feel that the children should go around and hug their dads. All children, go to your dad and go give them a hug. Praise the Lord. Get the fatherly blessing. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Can we please stand up for the benediction? Let's sing this song. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Give him praise, give him thanks, give him all the accolades. He's the father of all fathers. Open your mouths and give him praise. Thank him for today's service. Thank him for the weather. Thank him for the attendance. Thank him for the word of grace that came forth about fatherhood. Thank him for the deliverances that took place in today's service. Thank him for the testimonies that will be bettered by the reason of today's encounters. Give him praise. Give him praise. Begin to speak into your week. Declare that this week is a fruitful week, a safe week. No bad news will come. This week you will go out and come in safety. Whatever you put your hands upon, they will prosper. Open up your mouth. Decree how your week will be. His presence will go with you, will go before you. His presence will encamp around you. This week you will not lack, you will not suffer shame. This is your week of testimony, your week of breakthrough, your week of upliftment. Open up your mouth and just prophesy into your week. Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, may the Lord bless you. May the Lord strengthen you. May he lift up your head. May his face shine upon you. May he keep you. May he go before you and make every crooked path straight. This week, lines shall fall unto you on pleasant places. Your garments will always be white. Your head will not lack oil. This week, men shall bless you. Your heaven will be permanently open. In the name of Jesus Christ, thank you, Father. Can we please take the grace? Shh. surely. Amen. Hallelujah. The altar is open and the choir will lead us in some few praises.
Thank you, Lord. Please, before the choir leads us, we just want to let the church know that we appreciate those of us that are taking the place of men, taking the place of women. We do not, we have not forgotten about you. Maybe you are there, you are the one being the father, or you as the man, you have to take both roles. The Lord recognizes you. We appreciate you. The Lord will keep encouraging you in Jesus' name. So we just want you to know that we love you. We appreciate you. The Lord recognizes what you are doing, taking both roles for one reason or the other. We love you. We appreciate you. The Lord will keep encouraging you. You are honored today as well in Jesus' name, because you know it's not an easy thing to be either both father and mother either way. God bless you. We love you.
Praise the Lord.